Dear student, this video is about change of accounting date. So first of all, you should know that when change of accounting date is permitted and if the conditions have been satisfied, then how to find out the new basis period that is pertaining to the new accounting date. So first of all, we have to see that how long is the basis period in the year the accounting date is changed. Remember one thing, that the first tax year and the last tax year might be different from 12 month period, but in between, in the second period or in the second last period, the tax year is always of 12 months. So that will make it easy that whenever you are planning a tax period after first year or before the last year, keep in mind that that tax year cannot be less than 12 months or greater than 12 months. Now, in case of a change of accounting date and the new year, the new date which you are making is less than 12 months, then it will create further overlap profit. But if the new date creating more than 12 month period, then the earlier overlap profit will be relieved. Now, how we can find out the new basis period? So we can apply it through some examples. So for example, let's discuss the first example. So assuming that a sole trader is preparing the accounts for an accounting period of 31st March. Now he's planning to change the accounting date to 30th June. So you can see that 30th June is after 31st March. Now he's thinking about to change it for the 3 month period subsequent to March, 3 month period to 30th June. Now this is the results: tax adjusted trading profits, year ended March 19. It's year ended March 19 and the profit is 60,000. Then the change of accounting date, that is 3 months ended 30th June 19, and the profit of 3 months is 20,000. Now the subsequent is now onwards to new date, that is 30th June 20, and the profit is 85,000. Now we have to identify trading income assessment for the tax year 18 and 19 to 20 and 21. Now let's apply the change of accounting date. So first of all, just see that the basis period that is given to you is previous date that is given to you is 31st March 2019. So as per the tax year, let me just identify that first tax year. So the tax year and the relevant basis period and the assessable profit. So the tax year for this is 18 and 19. Basis period is year to 31st March, that is the current year basis, and the profit assessable is 60,000. So that profit is assessed in the tax year 18 and 19. Now the next date, you can see that the date is in 30th June 19. So the tax year becomes 19 and 20. But the problem is that up to 31st March, we have already paid tax and the new date is ending 30th June 19. So up to 30th June 19, there will be a new tax year because it's all, I already told you that the tax year is always 12 months. So it's up to the new accounting date, we have to cover 12 months. So if you do that, if you cover 12 months, you can see that the 12 month period would be starting from 3 months from this and 9 months from the previous. So the previous 60,000, 9 months from this, that is 60,000 multiplied by 9 by 12, and that is 45,000. This is overlapping. And the 3 months, which is new, and that is 20,000. So the tax assessable is 65,000 in the tax year 19 and 20. And you can see that clearly there is an overlapping of 45,000 because this 45,000 is already being paid. Now the tax year next becomes 2021 and it's normal the year end 30th June 20 and the profit given is 85,000. So in this way, the overlapping is of 9 months and the amount of overlapping profit is 45,000. Now let's move to another example following this. Now in the above example, now assume that instead of 30th June 2019, let's assume that we are preparing a 15 month date, and that is 30th June 2020. And tax adjusted profit is 1,05,000. Now, if you follow this example, you can see that 30th June 2000 and 30th June 2020. Now, if you can see that 30th June 2020, and that is the 15 month accounting period. So our period end at 31st March 19, and the new date is 30th June 2020. So that means accounting period is of 15 months. And if you follow that date, you can see that that date falls in 2021. And we have previous period is 18 and 19. So we have to create a 12 month period that is in 1920. So how we can create this 12 month period to the new accounting date? And that would be the exactly we have to put here. So let's start the first tax year, the basis period and the assessable profit. So first one is the previous date 18-19 year to 31st March 19 and assessable profit was 60,000. Now the new date is 2021. So from the 30th June 19, go back 12 months, that is 1st July 18. Because if you start from 30th June 20, then there will be a tax year missing and it's not possible to miss a tax year. So you have to create a tax year that will be as per the new accounting date that will end at 30th June 19 and will begin at 1st July 18. Now, if you follow this, so in this way, there will be a 9 month previous year profit, same as in the above example, up to 31st March, that is 45,000, and 3 month profit would be from the new one, that is 105,000, and this is 3, and the total period is 15 months, and as a result, we have 21,000. So total profit assessable is 66,000. Now, obviously, the next year would be 2021, and that would be to the exact date 30th June 2020. And in this way, we have to consider the 12-month profit, 1,05,000 into 12 by 15, so it's 84,000. Now, you can see that there is an overlapping same. So both the examples, the overlapping profit, further overlapping profit, that is 45,000. Now, in order to distinguish it from the above example, let's create a different example that might relieve some overlapping profit. So take another example. For example, you can see that a business has started from 1st July 16 and prepare accounts to June. Now, decided to change the date to 30th September. So 30th September, it might be after 3 months, but he's preparing to 30th September 19. And the tax adjusted trading profit detail is given as year end 30th June 2017, and there is a profit of 18,000. In the subsequent year, the date is same, and there is a 24,000 12 months profit. Now the date has been changed, its period ended 30th September 19, making a period of 15 months. And then subsequently, the new date is applicable, that is 30th September 2020. And there is a profit of 36,000. Identify assessable profit of each year. Now, as you can see that first, it's a commencement of the business. So we'll start from the commencement rule and apply the normal commencement rule, that is commencement to the following 5th April. So you can see that this is the case of 12 month accounting period. So this is tax year, this is basis period, and this is assessable profit. So the first tax year, it will start from the commencement date, that is 1st July 16, and will end at following 5th April, that is 5th April 17, making it 9 months. And the profit that is given to us is 18,000. So 18,000, but the assessable profit is only for 9 months. So it's 13,500. It's called actual basis. And the tax year is 5th April 17 means tax year is 1617. Now the next year would be 1718 in its 12 month up to 30th June 17. 30th June 17, 12 months profit. And that 12 month profit is based on current year basis, total 18,000. Now clearly there is an overlapping in between, and that overlapping is of, you can identify the date and you can identify the overlapping amount. That is 13,500. Now, after this, there is another previous date. So we'll use the current year basis in the tax year 1819. Current year basis, that is year to 30th June 18, and identify the profit, that is 24,000. Now, we have a change of date. So change of date is after this, there is a change of date, and that change of date is within the next year, that is 1920. So change of date is in such a way that is it's 19 and 20. Year to 30th September 19. Now we can see that if you move along 30th September 19, the period is of 15 months. From June 18 till September 19, the period is of 15 months, but the tax year cannot be greater than 12 months. So what we can do, take the whole profit, 15 month profit that is given in the question, that is 30,000, and as it's more than 12 months, so use the overlap relief. The overlap that is created in the first year, 13,500, you can get relief of 3 months. So 13,500 overlap was of 9 months. You can get 3 month overlap relief. And as a result, there is an overlap relief and the profit becomes 25,500. Remaining overlap profit. So original overlap was 13,500. You get some relief due to change in accounting date, 4,500. So it's 9,000 remaining. Now in the next year is 2021, and that is the normal current year basis, year to 30th September 20, and the whole profit is subject to tax, that is 36,000. So in this example, we have created a new date, and that new date is beneficial to us so that we are able to get some relief. Now, if in a state of 30th September 19, if someone tries to make a 30th September 18 date, then again there will be a case of further overlap profit, and this is a problem. So you have to choose the date in such a way that if there are any other overlap profit, you can get the benefit of overlap profit in the form of relief. So whatever is the date available to you, just check it out and remember that the new date will be recorded in such a way that the tax year cannot exceed 12 months or less than 12 months.